Якраз перед раптовими змінами політичного життя провінції Онтаріо минулого тижня ми записали розмову з прем'єром Онтаріо Кетлін Уинн про потреби нашого багатокультурного суспільства в Канаді.
Ідеї, зусилля, успіх. Спонсоровані Українською кредитовою спілкою.
Дорогі глядачі, вітаємо вас на українській телемережі «Контакт». І ми сьогодні маємо надзвичайно велику приємність привітати тут, на нашій телевізійній програмі, прем'єру провінції Онтаріо, пані Кетлін Уинн.
Welcome. That was a short welcome in Ukrainian.
Thank you, Yuri. I guess that's what it was. Thank you
Madame
very
Premier,
much.
Thank you very much for having us here. And we have a few little issues that, let's say, from the perspective of the Ukrainian community, but they're all really reflective of the whole multicultural community that we have here in the province of Ontario. Some of them relating to education, some maybe would like to discuss ethnic media with you, and but sort of in the upcoming news, health and the planned visit of Minister of Health, Dr. Hoskins, to Ukraine.
Yes.
And I would like to just start off to say that during the visit to Canada and Ontario of the acting Minister of Health, Dr. Suprun, we were invited to a meeting with the Minister Dr. Hoskins, and I thought it was a photo opportunity. But it turns out there's a lot of synergies there, and I gather it's your insight into these synergies and the potential growth that allowed you to okay this visit.
Yes, and I'm very excited that Minister Hoskins and Ivan Baker are going to be traveling to Ukraine. I think that it is it's a very important opportunity. We have a great working relationship with the Ukrainian community in here in Ontario, but also Ukraine and Canada are great friends, and so I'm really pleased that they are going to be able to have an opportunity to sit down, understand each other's perspectives and opportunities, because I think that there's a lot of work that can be done in medical technology, for example. I think there's innovation that we can find together. I think that there are opportunities for distance medicine, telemedicine. So I'm very excited that they're going to have an opportunity to travel.
Well, you mentioned Ivan Baker. We were at a meeting just a few days ago where Ivan assembled a group of specialists, the Canada-Ukraine Foundation, that has led a few medical missions to Ukraine. A few of them under the directorship of plastic surgeon renowned Dr. Oleg Antoneshin, and they were all at this table planning this out. So, and as an aside to Ivan Baker, we'd like to make a pitch. We in the Ukrainian community consider him to be a very capable and able individual. So, I don't know, your next cabinet change tomorrow, we would welcome Ivan in that position.
Well, he's such a hard worker. He's a wonderful young man, and he traveled with me a few months ago to Northern Ontario, and he is just he's a great young politician. He's got a bright future ahead of him for sure.
Very nice. So a thing that I would like to mention, during the past meeting that you had with the Ukrainian community,
yes,
one of the issues was raised was education, and it specifically related to the topic of Ukrainian heritage schools, and I'd say same applies to all or many different...
The international language program.
Yeah, the international language and heritage programs for individuals, and it was brought up that this is very much available for people that are close to centers where a school is viable. Mm-hmm. And the president of the Ukrainian National Federation, the oldest Ukrainian organization in Canada, 85 years, that runs these heritage schools throughout Canada and has two of them in Ontario, was suggesting the possibility of these heritage schools sort of being a potential template for online learning and helping people that don't have access to where the mass numbers are.
Right.
And maybe that's something that could be implemented, because I do understand that for certain Aboriginal groups that are outside of
yes.
territories have that kind of online access. So a template exists, and maybe we can stretch that to this kind of
thing. I think it's a very good idea. And actually, as a result of that conversation, the Ministry of Education is looking at what those options could be. Because the issue that was raised is in urban centers, it's easy to get together 25 students in a particular school, and then the funding is there to have the heritage language class. But that's not the case, as you say, in some parts of the province. So the Ministry of Education is looking at that. And you know, it demonstrates why it's important that we have those discussions, that we have those meetings with the friendship groups, and that we actually hear policy concerns from people who are on the ground. And so, as I say, as a result of that, the Ministry of Education is looking at what the options are.
Well, I'd like to take this opportunity to thank you for your personal involvement with our community, visiting our festival over the years.
And always wonderful. And I get wonderful clothing.
Well, you know what? And that clothing shows up the next year.
So I know. So
I think there's tremendous, I don't know, it's to thank your closet or your staff. But I remember.
No, that's all me.
That's all you.
Beautiful, beautiful handiwork.
Yeah, beautiful Fabarini dress made in Ukraine.
Beautiful.
That you brought out. Yeah. And we see that you understand and that the political system understands the multicultural aspect of our society. But there's a media issue, or two media issues, that I would like to bring up to you. One is that government advertising, be it federal or provincial, completely misses and does not trickle down to the ethnic programming
community.
And I think there's some kind of an institutional thing in there where it's the mainstream media that gets approached. So that's one issue, and we'd like to wonder how that could be.
Yes, and this has been raised with me by a number of outlets. So Minister Laura Albanese, who's our Minister of Citizenship and Immigration, is very aware of it, and she's from the media herself.
Yes, yes.
She is very concerned
about
it. We've
met with her a couple of times.
Yeah, she has a personal investment in it. It's got to do with how the procurement is done from government, and the availability of data on the different ethnic press and multicultural outlets. So we're trying to work it through, Yuri. We're trying to find a solution. We're not there yet, but we need to figure out how to have the maximum accountability so that the government procurement process can engage the smaller outlets. So that's the work that Laura is doing. But you know, I really feel strongly that there should be as much support for a broad range of community. Both some of the small, non-multicultural, small English, mm-hmm. but also the multicultural outlets. You know, it's interesting to me that sometimes it is the ethnic press, it's the multicultural press that actually reaches your communities more than even the other mainstream media. And we need to be aware of that.
And that's the point. And I think you understand it on a political level, but on a bureaucratic and procurement level.
And we're trying to bring those together.
Okay, and then the other issue is on a governmental level, and we see this with the Bloor West Village Ukrainian Festival, that there are programs that the government supports, and one has to do things very carefully, and it's not a free giveaway; you have to earn it.
Yeah.
But we see that in the festivals and productions mm-hmm. area. But at the same time, in the media area, in the media procurement, we, as different from the advertising, mm-hmm. the access to funding, we as ethnic media are almost immediately disqualified from applying in those instances because of the descriptions for who can apply.
So are you talking about, at first I thought you were talking about like the Celebrate Ontario funds for festivals, because
it applies well to us and we can
apply. You can apply for that. Yeah. But so which?
So there's the media funds that are both federal and provincial.
Okay.
Ethnic producers or ethnic agency are almost automatically disqualified from participating in the programming that's offered there.
Okay, well, again, that's something that we should look at separate from the advertising. And I'd be, you know, I'd be happy to have a group of people come in and talk to me, because I'm not as familiar with that one as I am with the advertising.
Yeah, but we had a Canadian Ethnic Media Association had a planned meeting with your Minister of Culture, Tourism, and Sports. Yep. Sports. Minister McMahon, but she fell sick at that point. But Madame Albanese came in and spoke. So she's aware of both aspects of both the procurement in terms of media buying, as well as access to government.
Well, we have a new Minister of Tourism, Culture, and Sport now, Diane Verniel.
Yes, that's right.
From Kitchener. So it might be a good idea to sit down with Diane. Yeah. And she also comes from the media. She, Diane Verniel, was a broadcaster as well. So we have a lot of people who understand media in our caucus.
Okay. Well, thank you very much for that kind of insight, and we appreciate time spent with you.
Well, I want to thank you. You know, I say this at the festival. You are a very, very cohesive community, and you support one another. And I'm always impressed at the emotional connection with Ukraine when I'm in your gatherings, and the hard time that people in Ukraine have gone through and go through. So I just want to extend my support to the community, and to say also that we're working very hard. You know, some of the changes we've made, and we've talked about them, the OHIP Plus, so that young children have access to prescription medicine, and the increased minimum wage, and free tuition for young people. All of those are things that we're doing that support all communities, and I hope that people in the Ukrainian Canadian community feel the benefit of those.
Yes, we do, and thank you very much.
Thank you.
Дорогі глядачі, це була дуже приємна, цікава розмова із прем'єром провінції Онтарія пані Кетлін Уин. Повертаємося до програми відразу після наступних реклам.
Ідеї, зусилля, успіх. Спонсоровані Українською кредитовою спілкою.